Okay guys, I'm going to put my my little doodads in here, these little inserts which hold my brackets on. I'm going to get a bit of this stuff, might have to get my fingers in it. But basically I want these holes kind of fairly well stuffed with this stuff. Get your fingers in there guys, good for you. Guys, there you go, there's the back ones done. As soon as that gels up, I'll be in like a rat in a drain pipe to cut them round. See, these things go in, these little collars. Now I've got my inserts, I can bolt them in after, and they latch down. There's my brackets on, rubbed off all the gnarly carbon. We're clipped on here. Basically, that undoes, boom. And so that's my other two brackets on there. That slips in, right? And then clips down. It needs adjusting down more. So there you go, guys. That's the hatches done. Alright people, here I am. It's time to put the white foam now on the bottom of the board. You see where I left it open, I don't need it open anymore. Got myself some permanent glue, spray glue. It's the same as I used on the top. It's in French guys, but colle permanente is permanent glue. And I'm basically going to go like the clappers, because I've got to do both sides, the foam and the board. Less babble, more action. Here we go guys. Plan comes together. I'm measuring from each side to the rail edge, and any difference I'll take off with some sandpaper. Basically, we're pretty good there. I'll give you a look, guys, with the handheld. That's on there. I've got to go along with my little block. You see, with the thickness, and keep that rail looking kind of thin, you know, as thick as I want the board, you know. If I come right to the edge with that white foam there, it just makes it look a little bit fat. I already tried it out, you know. So anyway, now you can see why I left it open. For all of this work I did, all getting into the hatches, making those fit properly, leaving this back portion out now so I can carbon right up to this bulkhead here, and then finally stick that top piece in. Alrighty, here we are, done the back end there, carbon at the very back is done. I carboned inside the middle hatch with a piece that I had left, a sort of a little bit rough, but it's in there. I've got one piece left before my new stuff arrives, hopefully to do the whole board. I'm going to cut some small holes here just to give me an alignment up from underneath. I've marked where they actually go, the drives, but I'm not going to dig them right out yet. Painted it black, why not? Yeah, it takes time, so I did it. That gives you a rough idea of the look of the beast. I redesigned my lines down the back here. My handle things, I've just still got to come in and just sand it lightly round to get that flush. But they're fine. I had to extend my back of my drive slightly with some of that pre-mixed resin. So I'll sand all them up nice. But what happened was, I put this transom plate in. That's straight up and down, but the bottom actually curves away. So these had a bit of a gap under the bottom there. So when I put it in, it was floating. Cut the bits of tape round, filled in with some of that stuff, that gunk. And then I'm going to carbon it before I rub these down anymore, so that they're exactly just square to the transom. When I bolt it up, it's nice and sealed all the way round. Hey guys, just a little update here. I'm scrubbing in my water slides, water whatever they're called, directional bloody whatever. Anyway, I made a block the size that I want, so I've kind of done this one over here, then I'll go along the sides eventually. So I thought I'd show you this, guys. We're just going in nice and easy first, just worrying about one side against the line. And that's it really, just keep sort of rubbing that back and forward to a depth that I'm happy with, and just going up to the line I've drawn across here, about 40 centimetres. Still got more to come off here, but I don't want this to get too wafer thin that it's going to be hard to keep nice. There we go. I've got them down to roughly where I want. They're going to need a bit more yet, but because they're flexing, you see here, once that's carbon, it'll give me a nice, more solid of a surface to get these really straight. When it flexes, you know, you're pushing pressure different places. I just wanted to get them going, and then once it's carbon now, I can come in again and make them nice and bring them into the drive so they're curving actually in. And there you go, guys. I'll be back with more. Stay with it, eh? We're getting there. Drives look good. I'll get these out and I'll carbon the inside.